So good morning, students. Today I will explain you about two measuring method of measuring quantities. Those are velocity and liquid level measurement. So how we can find out velocity in terms of so electrical nature. So we need to means we should use some type of transducers so that they will convert whatever the velocity or a liquid level into measurable electrical voltage. Okay, as you know, the velocity is a first derivative of displacement. Okay, so the first derivative of displacement is nothing but v equal to what, dx by dt. So linear velocity, so coming to the linear velocity is nothing but rate of change of position vector with respect to time at an instant of time, at a particular instant of time, that we call as a linear velocity. So we can find out the linear velocity by using a transducer called electromagnetic transducer. So this electromagnetic transducer, this utilizes voltage. So whatever the induced EMF or whatever the voltage produced in the coil on account of change in flux linkage resulting from change in reluctance. So that means whatever the that means there will be a moving coil. So moving coil linear velocity is directly proportional to the voltage induced in that coil. Okay, so we can measure the voltage by using two methods. So one is by using two transducers. So one is a moving magnetic transducer and next one is a moving coil transducer. We'll see moving magnet transducer. So in moving magnet transducer, a sensing element, so that is a rod type permanent magnet is coupled between devices whose velocity is being measured. Okay, so a rod type permanent magnet is placed between two coils. Okay, so that a permanent magnet, a rod type permanent magnet is moving. So whatever the velocity is there, that velocity produced is directly proportional to the induced voltage or induced EMF in the magnet. Okay, so the coil is surrounded by permanent magnet. So motion of the magnet induces a voltage. So here the voltage is converting the velocity is converting. So motion is nothing but the velocity is converting into a voltage. Okay, induced means the internally developed within a coil. Okay, so the amplitude of the voltage, so the value of the voltage is directly proportional to the velocity. So that means if velocity increases, amplitude of the voltage increases. So voltage increases, so it's directly proportional. So coming to the polarity, so the negative or positive voltage is determines the direction of motion. Suppose if it is a clockwise, you are getting the positive voltage. If it is an anti-clockwise, you are getting a negative voltage. Okay, so depends on the direction, it gives the polarity of the output voltage. Okay, so this is a velocity measurement diagram. So here there is a rod, there is a permanent magnet, a rod type permanent magnet is placed between two coils. Okay, so this is moving, so that means this is moving between the two permanent magnets. So there is a velocity, so that velocity is converted, so due to movement there will be a flux, it cuts the flux generated between these two coils. Okay, so due to this velocity, so whatever the velocity is there, that is directly proportional to the EMF induced in this coil. Okay, output voltage, here you are getting output voltage. So when a coil is placed in the magnetic field, the voltage is generated. Okay, so that voltage is nothing but E naught equal to what, E naught equal to this equation, E naught equal to BANV. So here B is nothing but flux density, so Weber per meter square, and area, A is area of the coil, and N is the number of turns. Okay, and V is the relative velocity of a magnet with respect to the coil. Okay, so as I told you, whatever the voltage E naught is produced in the coil is directly proportional to the velocity. So that means, so if you consider this k, so that means if you take the proportionality constant, so what you are getting, E naught equal to k into v. So E naught equal to k into v. So this k equal to what? K equal to, so b, you can find, you can place ban, here ban is there, no? So this ban you can replace with k as constant. So that means if you remove this constant, so whatever the velocity produced in this coil is directly proportional to the EMF generator or voltage induced in the coil. So this is how we can find out the velocity in terms of voltage. Okay, next one is so advantages. So if you see the advantages, so maintenance require, maintenance is negligible. Okay, maintenance of this moving magnetic coil is negligible, and output is linearly proportional to velocity. Okay, disadvantages, if you see, so some performance will be affected by the stray magnetic field, and due to this performance there will be some causes of noise. That means there will be some unwanted signals will be generated within the coil. And next, frequency response is usually limited to, and it is stated, and this is not applicable for measurement of vibrations. Okay, so for calibrations of this vibrations, it is not suitable. So this is only useful for measuring the linear velocity. So these are the disadvantages of this moving magnetic coil. And next, moving coil type velocity transducer. So this moving magnetic moving coil type means a coil is placed between this at the pivot. Okay, a coil is placed at the pivot between the two permanent magnets. So it is moved between these two permanent magnets. So here also, whatever the motion of the coil is there, that is a so due to this motion of the coil between the two permanent magnets, there will be induced EMF in the coil. So motion of the coil or velocity of a coil is directly proportional to the voltage generated in the coil. So that means here voltage generated in the coil is is proportional to the velocity of a coil. Okay, so whatever the velocity measured is applied to arm. So when you are applying to the arm, so coil moves in the permanent magnet. So here also we can find out the velocity in terms of voltage. Okay, so this is how moving coil type of velocity transducer will work. So still now we are seeing about the linear velocity. In order to find out the angular velocity, so we are using two types of transducers. Those are tachometers. So one is a DC tachometer and a AC tachometer. So we are using this tachometer as a mechanical transducer. So this tachometer is nothing but it's a measuring a transducer which is used to measure the angular velocity. It consists of a shaft and a total number of revolution during the period of contact, indicating directly number of revolutions per minute. Okay, so whatever the induced EMF generated, that is proportional to here rotational velocity. So if you see the DC tachometer, so it consists of we can find out the angular velocity by using DC tachometer and AC tachometer. So first DC, if you see the DC tachometer generator consists of small armature which is coupled to machine whose speed is to be measured. Okay, so armature is involved in the field magnet, and EMF is generated proportional to the product of flux and speed. So see here, if you see here, this one is the DC tachometer. So there will be an armature. Okay, this is an armature revolving between the two magnets. Okay, and there are brushes. So due to this angular velocity, an EMF is generated in the brushes. So from this brushes, by using moving magnet voltmeter, we can find out the voltage. Okay, there is a series resistance. So we are connecting the series resistor to limit the current. Okay, in order to limiting the current, we are connecting the series resistor. Okay, So see here. So this armature, whatever the armature is there, that is revolving in the permanent magnet. Okay. So EMF is generated is proportional to product of flux and speed. So as the flux is constant, so here whatever the voltage generated is proportional to the speed. So here angular speed. So that means the voltage generated in the tachometer is directly proportional to the angular velocity. Okay. So we can keep flux as a constant. Okay. So polarity of output voltage depends on the rotation. Okay, either the armature is moving clockwise or anti-clockwise, that depends on the direction we will get the positive or negative voltage. Okay. So whatever the EMF generated, that is measured by using a moving coil voltmeter. Okay, by using moving coil voltmeter, we can find out the voltage. So as I told you, the series resistance is connected in the circuit for purpose of limiting the current from the generator. Okay, for limiting the current in the generator, we are connecting a series resistance. Okay, so this is how we can find out the angular velocity in terms of voltage by using a DC tachometer. And next, AC tachometer. So before that, we will see the advantages. So whatever the rotation it is moving, so rotational velocity it is moving, so it is directly indicated in terms of output voltage. So here also it is directly proportional. So rotational voltage velocity is directly proportional to output voltage. So we are getting the output voltage in terms of 10 millivolts per rpm. Okay, we are getting 10 millivolts per rpm. Disadvantages, if you see, some maintenance are required for the brush. Okay, brushes for the small tachometer generators often produce some maintenance. So periodical maintenance is required for this DC tachometer. So input resistance of a DC tachometer is very high compared to output resistance. So in order to balance this, we are using a limiting the armature current to small. So how we are limiting means we are connecting a resistance, series resistance across this, so that we can limit the armature current to small value. Okay, so these are the advantages. AC tachometer, it consists of alternator, stationary armature, starter, and rotating field system. So that is rotor. So it consists of alternator, starter, and rotor. So alternating EMF is induced in a stationary coil. Okay, so when rotor is moving, the alternating EMF AC is generated in the stationary coil. So we need here moving coil voltmeter only measures the DC value. So here the output of the AC tachometer, you are getting AC and alternating EMF. We need to convert this alternating EMF into DC. Okay, so for converting this one, we are using a bridge rectifier. Okay, so at the starter, you are getting the alternating EMF starter coil. So this is alternating EMF is given to that bridge rectifier. So bridge rectifier will convert alternating EMF into a pulsating DC waveform. So that pulsating DC waveform is given to the C-section filter. So C-section filter will remove some ripples over there. Okay, you are getting the pure DC. So that pure DC can be measured by using moving coil voltmeter. Okay, this is how we can find out the angular velocity in terms of voltage. Okay, so see here. So whatever the ripples are there, ripple content is rectified. Okay, ripple content is rectified, and voltage is smoothened by capacitor filter. So here we are replacing. We are placing a bridge rectifier in order to convert alternating EMF to DC EMF. So pulsating DC EMF, and again it is given to the capacitor filter for smoothing. That means in order to remove the ripples, in order to get the pure DC, we are keeping a capacitor filter. So here, if you see, speed depends on the amplitude of the voltage. voltage and frequency. So that means if the amplitude, so speed, so speed increases, amplitude of the voltage also increases. Okay, so as they are both directly proportional, so as speed increases, voltage increases. Okay, so this is about the AC tachometer. Okay, so that means we can find out the angular displacement, angular velocity in terms of DC tachometer. So the DC tachometer directly it will convert whatever the voltage into direct whatever the velocity into direct voltage. Here AC tachometer at the starter you are getting the alternating EMF that is given to bridge rectifier. It will convert alternating EMF to pulsating DC, and pulsating DC is in order to smoothen and in order to remove the ripples, here is you are given to a capacitor. Okay, so by using moving coil voltmeter we can find out the voltage. Okay, so this is how we can find out the linear velocity in terms of voltage and angular velocity in terms of voltage. Okay, next, liquid level measurements. Okay, so if you see in industries, level of the liquid such as water, solvents, chemicals are very much important. That means then you need to find out the level of a liquid. Okay, how much quantity is there, so what is the property of a liquid, so that is very much important in the industries. Here also we can find out the level of a liquid by using transducers. So one is a direct method, we can find out by using the direct method, and next one is using indirect method. So in direct method, first direct method, so direct method, if you see, actual liquid level is directly indicated by means of simple mechanical type device. So we are using a floating operated scheme. So that means here what you are doing, a floating operated scheme we are using, that is acting as a primary transducer. Okay, whatever the float is there. Okay, so that is acting as a primary transducer. So this float will convert level of a liquid into displacement. Okay, suitable displacement. That suitable displacement is given to the secondary transducer, such as a resistive potentiometer or LVDT. As I told you, LVDT means linear variable differential transformer. Okay, so here what happens, if you see the diagram, so there is a float. Okay, this is a float. Float converts liquid level into displacement, and this is a wiper. So wiper is moving through the rheostat. So this this potentiometer, linear potentiometer, is acting as a secondary transducer. So this float will convert liquid level into displacement. So whatever the displacement is there, that is given to this potentiometer. So this potentiometer will convert the displacement. So wiper is moving towards this resistor. So when potential resistance changes, so that voltage you are getting in across this one. So that means level of a liquid is converted into voltage. So here also float is converted into displacement, and it is given to the rotatory potentiometer. Here it is given to the linear potentiometer, and here it is given to the rotatory. It will move rotationally, it will move between the rotatory potentiometer. So this is how we can convert. So this is a direct method. So this is how we can find out the level of a liquid in terms of voltage. Okay, so next is indirect method. In indirect method, if you see, hydrostatic pressure created by the liquid is directly proportional to the height of the liquid. Okay, so this is a pressure P equal to rho gh. So that means whatever the pressure created in the liquid is directly proportional to the height of the liquid. Okay, so for this purpose, what you are doing, a pressure gauge is installed in the bottom of the tank containing the liquid in the below. Okay, so if you see, there is a pressure gauge. Okay, so pressure gauge is we are replacing at the bottom and side of the tank. Okay, so rise and fall of a liquid causes the corresponding increase or decrease of the pressure, which is directly proportional to, so we have seen, so where there, if there is a rise in liquid, there is a change in pressure of the liquid. So there is a change in pressure of the liquid, there is a change in height of the liquid. Okay, so this is how we can indirectly we can find out the height of the liquid. Okay, so by using pressure we can find out the height of the liquid. Okay, so so we can find out the level of a liquid. Okay. Next is simple capacitor. So in the last class I told you, in the variable capacitance transducer, we are keeping the distance between two plates and area between the plates constant. So if dielectric is a variable, so we can find out the level of a liquid, no? So here also we can find level of a liquid by simple capacitor. There are two electrodes are there, okay, separated by thick small thickness of insulator called dielectric. Okay. So change in the liquid causes variation of the dielectric. Okay, so we are keeping the distance between two plates and area of the area between in the two plates constant, and we are varying the dielectric. Okay, so we can use here this is the diagram, liquid level measurement by using the simple capacitor. So these are the insulating metals. Okay, so these are the electrodes. Okay, so we are using air as a dielectric. So we can use air, vacuum, gas, or a solid as a dielectric. Here we are using air as a dielectric. As you know, capacitance is epsilon A by D. So that means here area is constant and D you are making as constant. So with respect to dielectric, capacitance is directly proportional to dielectric of a material. Okay, so that means if dielectric of a material increases, capacitance increases. Okay, if it is decreases, capacitance decreases. So that means if you see, if a level of a liquid is more, so if a level of a liquid is more, so what happens to the dielectric? Air will decrease, no? Dielectric will decrease, capacitance will decrease. So when the liquid level is empty, dielectric will be maximum value, as the capacitance will be maximum value. So like this, we can find out the capacitor level of a liquid in terms of a capacitance. So we can find out the change in the capacitance by using any of the AC bridge, as we have seen Maxwell bridge. So we can find out the unknown. So if you connect the change in the capacitance to the unknown Maxwell switch during null position, we can find out the change in the capacitance. Okay, so this is how we can find out the level of a liquid. So as you know that the magnitude of capacitance depends on the dielectric of material and varies with the area of cross section and inversely proportional to the distance of the two plates. Okay, so capacitance in microfarads is given by 0.0885 K by D. So if we are using air as dielectric, K equal to what? 1. So dielectric value is 1. So as I told you, when capacitance will be minimum when the liquid fills entire space of the electrodes. Okay, as I told you, when liquid fills entire range of electrodes, so dielectric means there is no air gap, so dielectric will becomes minimum. As dielectric becomes minimum, capacitance also becomes minimum. You are getting a minimum capacitance when there is a full of liquid in the electrodes. When there is a empty when the electrodes are empty, so what happens is there will be so much of air between two plates, so capacitor dielectric increases, dielectric will be increased to maximum value, and capacitance also increases to the maximum value. So this is how we can find out the level of a liquid by using a simple capacitance. Okay.